have a good time? Is everybody ready to have a good time? Yeah. Is everybody ready to have a good time? Yeah. Well, let's have a good time.
Yeah. It's Figaro Bonchi.
Boy, it sure feel good.
I just want to thank y'all for tuning in to this little Mexican thing we doing.
You know what it is. It's something different.
AKA Mr. Alfalfa. Mr. Tin Man.
Okay.
I'm just glad to be a part of the streets this evening. All right, then. Enjoy.
In this dream we call the world, exotic kush and golden curls. Summer dresses blow a breeze through your mind.
I knew it was coming, man. They closed down General Motors and they closed down that McDonald's on Salem. I used to work there. I'm the reason why they closed that motherfucker down. I used to steal everything out of that bitch. I'd walk around with nuggets in my pocket, apple pies in my sock. My partners used to come in there and be like, hook it up. I'd throw them a bag full of just like unwrapped food and shit. A bag with nothing but fries, a fish filet bun and shit. I was making up shit. That's when they had them arches. You know, the arches had that bacon that was round. I remember the first time that I took a lunch break and a nigga made a double cheeseburger and took that arch bacon and put it in the middle of the two pieces. And it was a white man that worked there. We used to call him Larry Bird because he looked just like Larry Bird. He saw that bacon and was like, you can clock out, you're fired. I said, I gotta find innovative ways to steal out this bitch. I walk out that motherfucker with a bag full of uncooked nuggets. I took that shit home. I couldn't get the grease hot enough. McDonald's grease is made in NASA. I don't know if y'all know that. I fried them motherfuckers in some Crisco. That shit was chicken flavored gummy bears. We was blowing bubbles with that shit. And my mom, she would be like, what time you get off on Friday? She talked to me all week then on Friday. She'd be like, what time you get off? Cause she knew it was payday and shit. I'd be like, 5. Why? Cause I need $50. Why? Cause I need it. My mama could smell some money on your ass. She'll turn pit bull on your ass about some money. She'll bite your goddamn throat. I get off on Friday. I had to go out to the car and shit. I remember one time I got paid on Friday and I bought a jacket off a nigga that worked there. It was a Tommy Hilfiger jacket.
No, it was a Nautica jacket.
Look, she knows. She talked shit to me the whole way home. Why would you buy that damn jacket? You don't even fit. I'm like, it's my money. Get out. She put me out the car. This your money, but I give you a ride every day. She put me out the car.
When they wanted to do stuff like, you know, they expected things like a blowjob and shit after only 29 dates. I was like, we ain't even been to Papa Do's yet, nigga. You keep taking me to Ling Ling's Buffet over there on Salem. I said, you trick. Can we at least get the date 30? Shit, I got a bad gag reflex. I suffer from PTSD. That's post-traumatic swallowing disorder. Shit, you trick. You suffer from that shit too, I hear you. Hold my breath, man. Fuck you. Pull your pants up. Nobody talking. I see your ass hanging out over the goddamn chair. That's you, juvenile. All right, you get a pass. How you doing? Ah, you some bullshit, because... No, I suffer from PTSD for real, because, you know, who remembers the first time they ever gave a blowjob? Put your hand down, sir. That question was not for you. Thank you. I'm gonna let y'all get that one in real quick. Man, first time I gave a blowjob, I was in the 8th grade. I know, right? I started late to the motherfucker, didn't I? Oh, now you this guy. Let's just call him Corey, because that's his name. He was like, you ever gave a blowjob before? And I was like, nah. But I'm sure it's pretty easy if all the white girls is doing it. Shit, it can't be hard, right? So we get behind the school, right? And he just pulls out his little pink thing. And I just go to town, just. Blowjob. Stupid, I know, because now I know that I'm older, how you do it. You gotta hold it with two hands. Don't try that trick at home. That's copyright. Yeah, some bullshit, because I didn't know what I was doing. Next thing I know, he puts his hands in the back of my jerry curl, shoves it down my throat. I ended up swallowing all of his children. And for the next 2 weeks, I was spitting on an EPT stick because I thought I was pregnant. Yes, I said spitting, because that's how stupid I was in eighth grade.
Cut it off. Did Clayton put this goddamn mic stand this low? Yeah. Or had it been here? Was it here already, Mama? You the Uncle Howard or you Uncle Howard? Which one is Howard? You Uncle Howard, nigga, you gonna catch a case next time you try to get on stage and touch Aga's booty. I see you, nigga. Ma'am, uncross your arms. You judging me back there with that white coat. I see three white people in this bitch. Hello. Three and a half, you light skinned and shit. Yeah, that's cool. It's Black History Month, and you niggas ain't clap for me. I didn't feel the love all the way completely. No, don't start now. No, you done already fucked up. I'm about to do this shit all over again. Clayton, I done seen you grab the liquor bottle, nigga. Bring it with you. Just come on and reintroduce me, nigga. I done came way to Dayton. Not to get disrespected. He said, I got 1 million views. I got 13 million views, nigga. Give me my millions. Bam, look. Old school. You ain't, is this, that's what you was talking about, Clayton, right there with the Chicago hat?
No, I didn't see him.
Okay, now you done threw up some shit. Hold on. Never mind. Nope.
That nigga like a retired gangbanger.
That nigga went like this. I don't know what it is, but nigga, let me leave you the fuck alone, amen?
That nigga was in Five Oaks back in the 60s.
This nigga jacking off air. I can't fuck with him. This nigga got log dick. He doing it with two hands down. Oh, my goodness. You the real old school player. That nigga, you ask him how he doing, he give you answer. Ain't got shit to do with how he doing. This nigga. Old school, how you doing? Hey, baby, can't call it, might spoil it. Shit, okay. That nigga went like this, was pointing with his thumb with the other hand, like that little nigga funny than the motherfucker right there. That little nigga. Get your little buck. Yeah, all right. Four other fingers pointing with his goddamn thumb. This nigga is amazing. I feel like they like me now, Clayton. Bring me back out, we gonna start this shit all over, act like none of this happened. What's up, Maria? Come on, La Flor. That's Selena's, nigga, don't act crazy. Hell yeah. All right, Clayton.
I was walking around today, boy, even the kids walk around here. Boy, what is y'all feeding these kids? They got asses and hips, and that's just the boys. My nephew, he 9. That nigga built like a church lady. He come up to me, my sister think everything he do is cute. He come up to me talking about, uncle, guess what? I said, what? These nuts. I said, yeah, but what about them titties, motherfucker? Don't forget them titties. No, because he know I love him, but that nigga is built like Aretha Franklin. That nigga come up to me, can I get a brownie? I said, yes, ma'am, you can have whatever you like. All right, I quit. Y'all give it up for my sister. She's pregnant with twins. And y'all know that I'm a twin. I was the underachieving twin. We have assemblies and shit. My brothers get trophies and what I get? I get a certificate of participation. Just some shit to say, yeah, he was there. This nigga was there. He was there. His shit be all up on the mantle and shit. My shit be on the Frigidaire. They use my shit for a dustpan. And now we 37. You gotta apply yourself early in life. I'm 37 years old. My brother, he is doing excellent in life. This nigga got A1 credit. My credit got H1N1.
But there is a difference between having relations with a pilgrim and everybody else. Because when it comes to having relations with a pilgrim and a brother, the rhythm. It's totally different. Like a brother will have his music ready, he's setting the mood. That's how I like that shit with a brother doing. With a pilgrim, though. With a pilgrim, I don't know what the fuck they be listening to. They just go, nigga, I be having an epileptic seizure and shit. Hit it! Yes, I like a... I like... Fuck it, bye. Nigga, it's the aftershocks of fucking with a pilgrim. I can't do it.
You ever give an old school player a good answer back? They take the shit personal like only they can give the good answers? You throwing at him, he throw one right back at you? Old school, how you doing? Hey, baby, can't call it, might spoil it. What's up with you? You like shit, slow motion. Better than no motion. Shit, too fast, run out of gas, nigga. You done ran out of gas off this bitch. This nigga a genius, nigga. I just ran out of gas yesterday. In Salem. These niggas got the real strobe light in this bitch, nigga. This is the cantina. We ain't even supposed to be here. We ain't old enough yet to experience this, nigga. This... Nigga still dance like this, getting in that motherfucker. Gonna turn around, Colin. Now, shit. Old school player, love the cha-cha, nigga. These niggas. I'm gonna leave you alone, old school. Listen, old school players got weapons you ain't never seen before. You know what I'm saying? He got a suede gun and silk bullets. He shoots you, you feel beautiful than the motherfucker. This nigga, bow, bow. You like, ooh. Shit, nigga, you out here busting like that, nigga? You fool. Bet you ain't gonna keep busting on me, nigga. You fool. Shit, you out here busting, nigga. Oh, that I'm leaving tomorrow morning. I'm leaving tomorrow. First thing tomorrow, because my mama can smell money. You got some money? My mama loved me, man. I love my mama. Give it up for my mama. My birthday is May 3rd. My mom still send me money every year. And I cash the check and give it back to her for Mother's Day. And give it up for her boyfriend, Sookie. I love Sookie. Sookie done earned his keep with me. I didn't know about that nigga at first. He's been around long enough. You put up with her, you are special. Because my dad, he ain't, I mean, I love him. My dad was crazy to the motherfucker. That nigga would do shit like start a fight on Friday, leave out and come back on Monday. It'd be some stupid shit, too. He'd be like, bitch, why the fuck you got the heat on? Like, because it's snowing. You know what? I can't live like this. I'm gone. That nigga would leave on Friday and show back up on Monday with a trunk full of groceries. That was his way of making up groceries. And I was just glad he was gone. He would show up with groceries, a tree at a Delta 88. You know how big that trunk was? He'd go to Cub Foods and spend $200. That nigga didn't buy flowers. He bought flour.
But I realized, you know, I always wanted to be an entertainer. I always wanted to look like Liberace and Michael Jackson and shit on stage all the time. And as soon as I got here, they said, who are you trying to save? I'm like, what? Shit, no. But I can't be behind a cubicle. Like, I just want to be an entertainer because I need a career where they don't drug test and shit, you know what I mean? Unless you die. Unless you roll over and flip your car three times and you a wrong way driver or something on the 71. That's just where I'm at. I got fired from one of the best jobs ever, my favorite job. How many of y'all been in Universal Studios Hollywood? Anyone? Yes. I was the character Scooby-Doo for 2 years at that theme park. And I got fired for putting my paws on somebody. Yeah, them pilgrims got a little bit too frisky for my taste. And me and Raggy went to town. It was a wrap. I got fired for breach of anonymity because I took the motherfucking head off and was like, nigga, I swear to God, all in a Scooby-Doo outfit, paws, feet, fur, everything. It was fucked up. It's fucked up. I love being Shaggy. I mean, Scooby-Doo. I was also Marge there, too. They had me fill in for Marge. That was a lot of fun because I ain't need that whole body apparatus because I had a big old tuchus, you know. But I ain't need all that. But anyways, that's why I want to smoke weed, because I'm tired. I can't do 9 to 5. I'm over it. But it scares me a little bit, because I see how people like to share weed after each other. And I don't know where y'all lips have been. Like, I can't do that shit. Okay, because my guy's an occasional weed smoker. But he also likes to eat all this buffet. So y'all will be getting puff puff ass if you share with that nigga. I'll let you know. Puff, puff.
One dude come in here with skinny jeans, and I've been trying to wait for this nigga to stand up so long. I don't know where he went. It looked like he had on skinny jeans and baggy boxers, and I'm trying to find this nigga. It looked like he had a blouse on underneath his pants. I swear I'm not the only one to see this brother. He probably still in the bathroom coming out like, nigga, shit. That nigga sound funny out here. Gonna take this nigga 625,600 minutes to get back to his goddamn chair. They got that song, Teach Me How to Ducky. Cause all the bitches love me. And ladies, I'm gonna tell you right now, he wasn't talking about women when he said bitches. He wasn't. It was 10 dude, well. It was 9 because I left early that day. I was in a music video. It was 9 grown ass men in the studio. Listen to how they decided to start this song. DJ, cue it up real quick. Don't play it yet. He didn't. You got it queued up? He did not mean women when he said bitches. DJ, play it loud real quick. Play it loud. Hey. Cut it off. Ladies, he was not talking about y'all. Fellas, he was talking to us. I don't give a fuck where you at on the coast. You could be in New York, Los Angeles, Dayton, Ohio. If you, Dayton is not a coast. You smart as shit, nigga. Light-skinned niggas always smart. Oh, that was the chicken eater. This nigga. I know you smart, nigga. This nigga walk like this, nigga. All the hood dudes, you ever find yourself in the hood club, Maria? Bobby? Becky, Sarah, if you ever find yourself in the hood club and you want to get out that bitch, roll up $20 and tell the DJ, say, play the Dougie. You got 4 minutes and 27 seconds to get your ass out this club, amen. I don't know what it is about Teach Me How to Dougie, nigga. It just sends a dancing spirit through you, amen. You start dancing like you was in the Abbey Lee Dance Company out this bitch. DJ, I'm gonna be a gangster dude real quick. Play it from the jump. Play it from the beginning. Hold on, this nigga here on Facebook, he ain't even fucking with the comedy show. This nigga on. You on August page. August, he trying to fuck with you. Any of your blood. This nigga here. Hey, play it from the beginning. I'm gonna be a gangster real quick. What? I was finna kill that nigga. Hey.
Teach me how to do it. Hey.
Hold my gun. It's my shit, my nigga.
They be like smooth. What? Can you teach
this
me?
This nigga's a gangbanger. This nigga
know why. Cause all the girls love me.
This nigga's a hardcore kill.
All I need is a beat that's super bumpin'. You pack it up and dump it. Put your arms out front. Lean side to side.
Hey, man, look. Dayton, Ohio. I really, really fucks with y'all. Y'all some good ass people. I appreciate the shit out of y'all. Salute. Much love. Thank you so much. Y'all give it up for my boy Clay Perkins one more time. Hey.
Like, I get dick pics now and be like this. Like, I hit the screen and shit. And like, why do you keep sending me a picture of your thumb? Give y'all some advice, fellas, okay? Because you got this whole table up here looking like the Real House Husbands of Troutwood. Yes, you like right. You look like the ringer. You got Juvenile at the table with you and shit. B40 and shit. God damn. Real House Husbands of Troutwood. Here we go. But I'm gonna tell y'all something. If y'all send dick pics, we gon' like as a woman, we just need a reference, you know? We need you to do like a side by side with a Fiji water bottle or like a Snickers bar. So we know which one gonna pay the bills and which one gonna fuck up our life. Like that's where we at. Y'all know. I ain't lying. Shit, I done met with so many niggas who did not realize I could not get a house on street credit.
Sad man. I don't miss the snow. I don't, man. I mean, I used to walk in the snow. Like it was nothing. Like, a girl would tell me, you want to come over? I'd be like, hell yeah, I'll walk. I walked 10 miles uphill for a kiss. Now I'm 38, nigga, I won't roll over in the same bed. Be like, my wife be like, you want to do it? I'm like, you better get on time.
We getting old, niggas, man. We old. This that age, like 38 is when you think about sex every day. But you only can do it every 4 days. Every 4 days. That's all my wife get is every 4 days. If we did it on Sunday and she walk around on Monday with some good, like, you know, with her little shit on, I'd be like, damn, I'm gonna tear your ass up on Tuesday. You gonna get it, though. Then give me 3 more days. I'm gonna tear your ass up. And I know some of y'all was like, damn, Clayton, I got big. Well, guess what? Y'all big, too. This used to be the gym city. This is the big boned city. I got a reason to be big. My wife is Mexican, so everything we eat got cheese in it. My wife put cheese in everything. Beans and cheese, and rice and cheese, corn and cheese, sour cream and cheese, wrapped up in a tortilla with cheese. I got a shit and I'm stomped up at the same time. Look, you Mexican, look, she know. Baby, look, that's your woman, yeah. Cheese and everything, and corn. Corn ain't even a vegetable. You can't even digest that shit. You ever been on the toilet and push so hard it was shit, piss, and cum in there?
Mexicans get jobs, bro. They do anything that you don't want to do. In Arizona, they work at black restaurants. Popeyes, they got a spot called Lolo's Chicken and Waffles. All Maria's working that motherfucker. They so precise, you get your food on time. They not bullshit, man. They got Popeye's Chicken. It's from Louisiana. They got Popeye's Chicken. All Mexicans work in Popeye's, fam. Swear to God. You walk in that bitch, be confused. You like, yo, let me get the carne asada chicken, please. You fuck with two of them jambalaya tostadas, fam. Cause one thing I know is black people, as much pride as we got, we ain't fucking with no Mexican food restaurant ever. You ain't never been in any Mexican food restaurant and seen Marquise working nowhere in the kitchen. That's all I'm saying. You can't have Marquise working in that motherfucker. He like, what's up, cuz? What you want, cuz? Fuck, can I take your order? What you want, cuz? That's on the menu, cuz. Just run it, my nigga. What you want, cuz? One or two. All right. You can't have Marquise working in that motherfucker. He in the back rolling burritos like blunts and shit. You like, hell nah, Keith. You don't run my shit back in that kitchen.
Feel good. I just want to thank y'all for tuning in to this humble looking thing we doing. You know what it is. It's something different. AKA Mr. Alfalfa. Mr. Tin Man.
Mr. Alfalfa.
Think about me, Gaga.